habitat for wildlife. Franklin Roosevelt has said, a nation that destroys soil destroys itself. Forests are the lungs of our land, beautifying air and giving fresh strength to our people. Due to increase in population, humans are cutting trees very frequently to meet their daily needs, which is very harmful for their survival. Tree cutting gives rise to a lot of natural calamities such as landslides, floods, soil erosion. And due to various factors such as development of industries, urban areas, forests and trees are depleting at a very fast rate. Throughout the world, about 900 million trees are cut every year. That equates to 2.4 million trees every day. These trees are used to make everything from paper and lumber to food products and to deodorant. Bangalore, once a garden city, on an average loses 10,000 trees in a year. Now let me share you some of the contributions of ordinary persons who have done extraordinary work to protect the forest. Kenyan government converted most of forest into land for agriculture and residential use. The government's deforestation program resulted in severe droughts and soil erosion. As a result, a young Kenyan woman by name Wangari Maathai started a movement called Green Belt Movement. Can you guess how many trees have been planted by this organization? Any guesses? It's over 51 million trees. She became the first African woman to receive the Nobel Peace Prize for her contribution towards sustainable development. Dr. Narayan Kaji Shrestha, one of the main architects of community forestry movement in Nepal, has spent 3 decades in promoting and restoring forest natural resources in that country. He guided earlier attempts to create more community participatory approach and reach more to women and other low-caste villages and initiating countries first user-managed forestry group. Salu Manada Timmakka, an uneducated woman, is an Indian environmentalist from our state of Karnataka. She is noted for work in planting and tending 384 banyan trees along a 4 km stretch of highway between Kulikal and Kudur. Her work has been noted and honored the National Citizen Award of India. She is sent to water them every day by carrying pots and pots of water. A US environmental organization based in Los Angeles called Timmakka Resource for Environmental Education is named after her. Today, Timmakka attends various afforestation programs in India. What did Wangari Maathai, Dr. Narayan Kaji Shrestha and Salu Manada Timmakka do differently? They took the responsibility of tomorrow. If they can take it, why can't we? We have a responsibility to look after our planet. Now, may I appeal you to take a pledge for the protection of trees?
Yes.
I request the audience to stand up. I want you all to quote this sentence by mentioning your name. I, Inder Kumar, pledge to plant a tree every year. Thank you. I would like to end this speech by quoting Winston Churchill's words. The price of greatness is responsibility. The price of greatness is responsibility. Let's take responsibility. Over to you, Toastmaster.